actually, I'm not going to prove the proposition in this form. I'm going to prove it in an equivalent form, which is the one that we used yesterday. So we had a situation like this yesterday. We had two open sets that was called like A and A1 or A1 in this, I don't remember. And we wanted to prove that if we take n point in here, we can get a whole neighborhood, a whole compact neighborhood of the point. Okay, this is the thing that I want to prove. Exactly the thing that we need for this theorem. That is, I repeat, equivalent to this formulation. But if you want to prove the difference, you can find it in any topological loop. Okay, to prove this fact, I need a little bit, a property which is a little bit stronger than the Hausdorff property, which is the T3. And do any of you know what T3 spaces are, or do you want to give you the definition? If you take a topological space in tau, we say that tau is T3, or that it's regular. If think about the Hausdorff property. In the Hausdorff property, you can separate a point to a point from a point. Okay. In here, it is more or less the same, but you can do more. You can separate a point from a whole closed set. Okay. So, is a topological space is T3 or regular if for all x in x and for all f in x closed, of course with x not in f, so point closed set, there exist two open sets, let's call it U and V, open and disjoint, such that X is in U and F is owing to the in V. So exactly this separation here, which is very a stronger separation than these two. And I need this concept to be proof, and I will use it even if in the proof of the Baire theorem we only have the T2 property, the Hausdorff property, because this fact, which is pretty interesting, that if you have a topological space which is Hausdorff and it's also compact, okay, so if X tau is T2 and compact, then it's also T3. And you can prove more if you know what T4 is. It's even T4, which I did not prove because we have 1 minute. And if you agree with me, I can give a short proof because it's a very big proof, and it's one of those facts that shows how compactness and power properties, because we can see that starting from T2 we can easily get to T3 just because of compactness. Okay, so very quickly, let's fix a point, fix x in x, and fix a closed set in x with x minus. So the situation there is backward. And we need to construct the two open sets which separates them. Okay, how can you do it? Well, we have the hypotheses of the Hausdorff, or the Hausdorff property, so we can see this. If we take any y in f, if we take any y here, since the space is T2, we can separate this point with just this point over f. And we can do this for all points over f. So for each y in f, there exists a uy and a vy, respectively neighborhoods of x and y. Such that they contain x, y, and they are disjoints. Okay, so what we can do is just consider the union of all those neighborhoods in N. Okay, so consider the union with y that there is in OF of the VY. This clearly is an open cover of F. This contains F and is open. We can take the neighborhood open, of course. It's an open cover F, and since F is a closed space in a compact space, F is itself compact, so we have an open cover. We can extract a finite subcover. So that exists y1, yn, say, in F, such that we can actually cover the OF with just this finite unit, j from 1 to n, of this yj. So we basically found a small neighborhood here. How do we find a neighborhood here? Since we have just a finite number of neighborhoods, we can just intersect all of them. Okay, since this is finite, we have a finite intersection of open sets, so this is still an open set. This is still a neighborhood of X, because all of those guys are neighbors of X. And this is still disjoint from if we call this one V and this one U, those two are still disjoints because the intersection is in particular included in each end of those, and each end of those is separated from this other neighborhood. Okay, so we're done. So we prove that for n point, for n open space, we can show two different neighborhoods, one of the closed set, which separates them. Okay, that's pretty easy. And that's all because of the compact.
YF is compact. You could just close, but you can take just.
Because we are in a.
But F is any closed subset.
F is a closed subset in a T2 and compact space.
You are speaking about compact spaces. Okay.
Yes.
Okay.
It's compact.
Okay. Effectively. Okay.
Yeah, that's the importance of the compactness on the upper space.
Sure.
And with this, we can prove what we need. We can prove that if we are in a situation like that one above, we can, in any open set, take a neighborhood of a compact neighborhood of the point and stuff it exactly in between a set without the boundary touching the boundary of the open set. So what we want to prove is exactly this fact, that if we have a topological space itself, which like in Baire Theorem is only T2 but locally compact, then if you take any open set in X, if we take any point X in the open set, we can find a neighborhood, let's call it B, neighborhood of X, let's say relatively compact or compact is the same. Compact, such that the closure of it, so B closed, closure in X of course, is all included in it. That's exactly what we need to complete the proof of the Baire Theorem, to convince you of the Baire Theorem. Thank you. Okay, we are in a locally compact space, so take Vixen on SMB, Vixen X. So we have this and we have this. Since we are in a locally compact space, there exists a VW in X, which is relatively compact. But this not necessarily is all inside it, can go outside. Okay. But it's relatively compact at least. So this is compact. Okay, what we want to do now is try to shrink this W and let it fit inside the open set. So how to do this? Think about this. VW, when you close it, is a compact set. Alright? We just proved that if we have a compact topological spaces, it's different. We're gonna need this property. If we consider this space here, the subspace with the subspace topology, sorry. And we use this notation here. So this subspace, all closed, is a compact space. So being a compact space, a compact T2 space, because also the Hausdorff property transfer into some spaces. Being a compact MT2 topological space is also different. Like proposition before. Okay, so let's intersect W with A and close it. I.e., let's consider this setting here. This, or at least the boundary of the W intersecting with A, is a closed set, because in a Hausdorff space, boundaries of all primes are closed. So this is a closed set. This is a point. Okay. This is a point. We are in a T3 spaces, in this space, sorry, we can separate them. We can actually find a neighborhood of the set, a neighborhood of the point, such that the two neighborhoods are disjoint. So of course, in particular, there exists, this is because of the T3, there exists a neighborhood that's called B tilde, which is a neighborhood of X in the space we are at, so in VW, such that the theta closed is all included in here. Okay? Because you can separate with more, we don't say, of course, you can separate also the boundary. So we have a neighborhood of X in W bar, which is not what we need, but almost, that does kind of what we need. So this is a neighborhood of X in VW. What does it mean? Let's say open, not a posto generale. What does it mean when we have, maybe I can answer this one? When we have an open set in the subspace topology, that means that it would exist some open set in the bigger space. So there exists some E in X open, such that our B tilde is this A intersected with W. This is exactly definition of open sets in subspaces, in topological subspaces. So we're almost done, because if we define V like this here, V intersected with V, or if you want it open, you can say it's open, we can even take the interior, which is not empty, because it's a neighbor of X. And this is still a neighbor of X, because E is a neighbor of X. V, VW, it was from the beginning a neighbor of X, so it's a neighbor of X, a neighbor of X, this time in X. So where do you want it? It is relatively compact. Of course it is. This was our V, VW, which is here. Now VW is all included in this compact space. So this is when we close it. When we close V, we have a closed subset in a compact space, so again it's compact. And we're done. We found our compact set, which is a neighbor of X, and which is all included in A in A. Because it particularly is included in VW intersected A. That's it. Any questions?
Thank you very much. I give you back myself.